In the last few years, wheat became the major commodity in most sub-Saharan African countries. Each year, wheat importation cost about $12 billion to African countries. SARD SC Wheat Project supports the agricultural research for development on strategic commodities in Africa, includes wheat as one of its principal commodities. AFDB founded the project SARD SC Wheat After the Wood after the food crisis of 2007 and 2008. The main objective of the project is to generate technology and transfer the know-how to 12 sub-Saharan African countries in order to ameliorate yield.
I was able to get the seed itself on credit. Even the providers with the micronutrient fertilizers that we spray on the wheat. And definitely we have observed differences and we are expecting more yield, particularly this year when the intervention reached so many farmers.
أما بعد أنا هاشم أحمد السماني تدربت في استفدت كثيرا من مشروع تعزيز الأمن الغذائي مشروع بنك التنمية الأفريقي اللي لنا. أولا احنا افتتح لنا مدرسة للمزارعين قامت بتدريبنا كل العمليات الفلاحية وتجويدها. كانت إنتاجيتنا في السابق من 4 أو 5 شوالات للفدان الواحد. بفضل يعني جهود المشروع يعني ارتفعت إنتاجيتنا إلى 18 جوال للفدان. وكنت من ضمن 20 مزارع تم تكريمه في الخرطوم وزارة الزراعة الاتحادية. اتنقلت التجربة بفضل مدرسة المزارعين على جميع أخواننا في الرابطة وفضل الله زرعنا 620 فدان تراوحت الإنتاجية متوسطة بين 10 و12 جوال للفدان الواحد بفضل هذا المشروع. 12 جوال في متوسطنا زرعنا مساحة 620 فدان. الآن اضافت المساحة إلى 1200 فدان بفضل الربحية اللي حققناها الموسم الماضي من الغنم. يعني سيدنا فائدة وصلة تمام.
كنا بنزرع القمح في السنين الماضية. طبعا القمح ده في أصناف متعددة وفيها خلط ما الشكل بتاع القمح ما كان زي الشكل بتاع السنة دي. يعني طبعا التراب ده طبعا تراب ناس البحوث تراب جميل وزي ما انتم شايفين على الحقل واضح وأدى دفع للمزارع كويس جدا. يعني القمح ذاته طبعا محصول غير محصول نقدي محصول استراتيجي يعني الدولة ذاتها بتهتم به شديد. وزي ما انتم شايفين طبعا هو الشكل قدامكم والقمح جميل. المزارعين ذاتهم متفانين في العمل يعني طبقوا كل الحزم التقنية في الزراعة دي هلا وصل للمرحلة الحمد لله.
الحمد لله لنا عامين بنزرع بالتقاوي إمام وهي الحمد لله متحملة السخانة ومتحملة الانتاجية في بعد كله انتاجية كويسة الحمد لله. الإنتاجية تتراوح ما بين 15 إلى 20 جوال للفدان وإن شاء الله نتمنى السنة دي تزيد من الـ20 ذاته. والتقاوي دي الحمد لله السنة دي كويسة شديد.
وكياني نايو كواناي نتاوندوكانا نومسكين
هوا
واتوتو وانوزا وقاسوما ألافو بيلي بيلي مين مونيو نتاكوانا هالي مليوناي
نتاكوانا هالي جاني
نتاكوانا ninapoenda mjini kuemea na mamsap mjini kumapanga
kwenye kwenye kagari
kwesi kulima miaka 10 kwa kilimo cha namna hii kwa kuwezeshwa na ndugu zetu wataalamu pamoja na wote wananchi wote.
We're expecting to have this higher than the previous experience we had. Yeah, because the knowledge we were applying before has now changed into new advanced technology after we were trained by our experts from research center. And from also the knowledge I got also from the training I got from Kulumsa research center.
Okay. That helped you a lot.
Sannan kuma mun sake samun yawan iyali. Ni nan na da aure. Na ina da matata guda daya. yanzu ina da mata na guda hudu gani nan kuma manomi ne ni ba kuma aikin gwamnati nake ba kuma na dogara da wannan noma ne na alkama yau gani kowa ya gani sai ya ga kamar kansilan kauye ne kuma noman alkama ce.
RDC project is aiming at bringing wheat production and productivity to increase in Africa so that Africa become food self-sufficient by producing its wheat within its continent more profitably and competitively. Africa today spends more than $12 billion to import wheat from other continents, and the continent is risking its food security in this very unsustainable import of wheat. So the best solution for Africa is for Africa to exploit its
own part. Plow Milling Association wishes to reiterate its commitment to supporting the local production of wheat. A practical demonstration of that commitment is our pledge to offtake all the wheat produced in Nigeria. In view of this commitment, we are actively working with the Wheat Farmers Association of Nigeria, the state governments of wheat producing states, as well as the Central Bank of Nigeria, to agree on the modalities for offtake.
And I also like to set another success of this program, which already has been stated by the Millers Association. They have sent us an official note, official intent letter, that they are ready to obtain all the wheat we produce this year in Nigeria. What is just remaining here is to put our heads together to have a minimum guarantee price that will allow the farmers to sell these grains to the off-takers, and it will also give the farmers the courage to produce more by next year.
I am happy to note very specially the pronouncements by the leader, chairman of the Nigerian Association of Millers, assuring that every grain of wheat produced in Nigeria has been certified to be appropriate in quality, and they are taking every single grain for processing or for milling in Nigeria. And I'm fully convinced that we have now attained the technical, scientific, human, natural and material resources to achieve our targets. The efforts of the late Child Research Institute, ICARA, CMYYT, delivering high-yielding, yield-tolerant food varieties, the potential of 6 tons per hectare is commendable, and government is proud of these institutes, and wishes publicly to congratulate them for their efforts. I acknowledge the support of the SARDC, the wheat project, in the promotion of mechanized farming through the provision of seed planters, seed cleaners, milling machines, and the establishment of commodity shops for women to showcase what wheat products can be in this country.
Increased production from over 3,000 hectares last year to over 10,000 hectares this year, and the output growth is over 300%. Encouraged by the fact that government under President Muhammadu Buhari is committed and serious, state governors are keen into the program, Central Bank is providing support, Federal Minister of Agriculture is encouraging the enforcement of what is imagined to be a national policy. The farmers became committed and they multiplied and they expanded their production. So we need to start working now, and I believe if we start now, Kebbi State alone can provide 70% of the 300,000 hectare target. And I believe other states can very well do more.
So much impressed with the performance of wheat in Sudan. We are impressed because all the team players are very effective. There is a teamwork approach in the production of wheat research. Once again, I want to thank SARDC for this unique opportunity they have given to Africa by promoting wheat production in Africa. In Nigeria, we have made remarkable achievement. As I said before, our wheat production was about 50,000 metric tons before this project. But as a result of the intervention of SADC and wheat ATA, our production rose within 3 years to 130.
Some time ago, nobody believed that we can grow wheat in this environment. And the breeders have broken the barriers, bringing the wheat from 1 ton, 1.5 to 6 tons. And they are going to go to 8.
And I think it's important for us to understand the implication of what he just said. Mm-hmm. You see, wheat is grown in a temperate, cold environment. It's not a crop that was made for tropical countries. Now, for research to have worked to introduce a variety that is tropical, which is it can grow inside of hot environments, but also to be adapted to that environment. And not only that, but to give you yield of 6 tons in a hot environment. I think for those of you that may not be scientists, you need to understand that is the difference between when you fly a kite. You know a kite?
Yeah.
The kite that we fly like this, and a plane. That's the difference.